Hi all and welcome. In this video, I'll just talk about a couple of topics and about a kind of wrestle with things and things to think about. So if you look at some of the earlier videos I produced, they were on silver coins and bullion. And you know, this is an alternative, of course, to the central banks and money and control of money and all these sorts of things. Rothschild control, Rockefeller control, bank control, these sorts of things. So there is a movement out there, you know, the cashless society and all this sort of thing and control. And I realize that, and I realize all the fears and that sort of thing. Personally, I try to get away from central bank issuance in my life and make transactions other ways, say via the Bitcoin network, which I find useful for transactions that are longer than the length of my arm, and I make many of them like many people these days, and I enjoy that, and there are good reasons to do that. I also have a silver bullion also and gold and that sort of thing also as part of sort of what I do. But anyway, so I support alternatives, but with the sort of cash thing, people sort of, it's like cash, don't let the cash go. But the cash that we have in society at the moment is kind of Rothschild, central bank, however you want to cut it, issuance. It's issuance from those entities, and I don't like that at all, and definitely would like complete alternatives to that. So yeah, just an interesting thing when people are kind of going, oh, beloved cash, like your beloved $1 notes and bills and what have you, from around the world. But it's issued from these bankers. Another thing I'd like to talk about is the kind of demonization of certain entities around the world. And I guess the Vatican comes up, of course, with this, and the Jesuits and the Freemasons and various, I guess, secretive societies and all these sorts of things. Looking at various speakers and things through the years to do with all this, many of the people who are approaching this happen to be Americans who are sort of vested in what I would call a perverted, what they term Christianity. I don't really think of them as Christians, but that many of them will think of themselves as Christians, who have a kind of what I think is a perversion of the Bible, which is really an esoteric book. They see it as an exoteric book, but anyway. So with America, for example, from what I can see, America, the Constitution and the basic setup of America and the freedom that America brought forth, and other countries like Australia, I think most of this will have been due to people within Freemasonry and other societies. So I have this wrestle. Other people don't seem to have this wrestle. It just seems to be demonization of this. I do wonder at times what our current societies would be like if these so-called Christians were really running the show. Would the world be any freer? I really wonder this. I really do. I even kind of look at myself and the situations where I've been in control. I have a history of, I was part of a warehouse type thing at one stage here in the city of Sydney, and there were people living there and various other things happening. It was a little bit of a squat in a way. It wasn't totally legal with the council and all the rest of it. And that place got squatted by a guy who was in his 50s, for example, and caused quite a big stir there. He was into his martial arts and stuff, and a potentially dangerous guy who liked to fight. And it was a very interesting thing that kind of squatters got squatted. And I've also come across the scenario of having a free man, an up-and-coming free man of the land, approach me because he wanted to do a rather serious job on another potential or another free man of the land, who had allegedly stolen about $18,000 worth in Australian dollars of bullion, silver bullion and a bit of gold bullion off this guy. So one freeman had stolen from another. So I, in my time, I've sort of lived through some of these scenarios, and life's complicated, and I do ask myself these things about people who, with this thing about the cash, this want for that kind of, in a way, central bank issuance, which I just disagree with. You know, we need alternatives, and silver and gold don't cut it. The counterfeit and all this sort of thing, you know, not unless we're bombed back to the Stone Age and all the rest of it, and I won't be around for that. I don't think I'll survive that. Also, the notion of just the demonization of certain entities. For me, I wrestle with this because it is... There are two sides to it. There are sort of freedoms that we have at the moment. Actually, I know the world is far from perfect. There is so much corruption that it drives me like absolutely crazy. But what would I be like in control, or what would someone else be like? Now, you know, I come from a slightly anarchistic sort of point of view as well. In fact, here in the city of Sydney, at the Anarchist Bookshop Cafe, the sign hanging in the window, that's actually my sign. I made that sign for that organisation. So I've never been part of it, but I know people, many people who have been in there in the past. So I'm no friend of the government, but I wrestle with all these things.